So the training is actually even more better, which is if you're responsible for security, you can gain your own training against your people so that when it's time to get a bigger budget, you can make the numbers of people who make mistakes go up so that you get a bigger budget. And then when it's time for your review to come, you can have 2 months of improvement so you can demonstrate the value of the organization. But the I think we are making progress as a security community. So usually a Twitter doc pile is nothing to celebrate. But recently at a very high profile technical conference, someone was captured on Twitter saying, someone was captured giving a speech, and his line was, there's always going to be some idiot clicking the link. And everyone in the security community piled on saying, no, they're not idiots, they're humans. It's your fault as a security person for having an infrastructure that allows a single click to break your blah, blah, blah. So I think on one hand, we're making progress as a community, understanding that users aren't idiots, they're users, they're not the enemy, they're people that we need to build infrastructure for. The challenge is how do you manage that risk in an efficient marketplace? So how can I work with Danny's company to make sure that we understand this? I don't have perfect answers for it. Danny can provide one. I'm not an ops guy for the US government, but I wanted to mention a recent program that DHS just rolled out, which is they are now keeping an eye on all .gov domains. And so if there's a change, they know whose beeper needs to go off to make sure that that change was supposed to happen. That's how an organization can actually take advantage of the fact that, hey guys, this is the internet. We have lots of data. Let's use it in as close to real-time feedback loops as possible.